Today, we're going to talk about marketing. Hey everyone, it's Mike from LandscapeBusinessCourse.com. Today I'm at Command Center, but today I want to give you another strategy for getting more mowing customers and landscaping customers in your business. So I'm going to talk about Facebook ads. Now in the past, we've talked about cheaper ways of getting ads, or getting new customers, I should say, and doing advertisements, whether it be door hangers or maybe some yard signs. But today I want to talk about Facebook ads, where you're gonna actually spend some money, you're gonna have to get a little more creative, you're gonna be a little more tech savvy. So today I'm actually gonna show you how to make a Facebook ad. I'm gonna show you the different types of Facebook ads and when you should use them. But the biggest differentiator between Facebook ads and other strategies we've talked about in the past is they do cost money. So this is not the best strategy if you just have $500 to get started with your lawn care business. You're gonna wanna go after door hangers or yard signs and more creative kind of boots on the ground strategies to get customers. But if you have some money to spend, Facebook is a great place to get started. So today I'm gonna talk about three main different types of Facebook ads. Not all Facebook ads are the same. When you create a Facebook ad, you need to know what is your intention and what is the call to action you're going to have for your customers. So let's talk about the three right now. First of all, though, we're in our lawn care Facebook page right now. This is Augusta Lawn Care Services, the local shop. On the left-hand side, you're gonna go ahead and click the Ad Center. This is the easiest way to get to your Facebook ads account. Now, you can go to business.facebook.com, but that's a very much more in-depth and analytics and things like that. So if that's not comfortable to you, if that seems foreign or hard, this is a great, easy strategy to create the ads and monitor them going forward. So I'm gonna click on Ad Center. You're gonna see here, this is the summary at the top of how much we've spent in the past 60 days. So they spent $900 in the past 2 months on Facebook ads. But I wanna talk today about the different types of ads, because see here, website visitors, then we have call now buttons, we have more call now button links, and then we have leads. So I'm gonna be talking about these three different types of Facebook ads. The first one is website visitors, the next one is a call now button, and the third one is called what we call a lead form. Now, if we jump into the computer here and we actually want to create our ad, you're gonna go here to the blue button, click create, create ad, and it's gonna open up, and the first thing it's gonna do is choosing a goal. Now, there are literally 10 different ways you can run Facebook ads. You can have get more calls, get more website visitors, get more bookings, get more website purchases, etc. For the landscaping industry, we're gonna talk about the three main ones. Get more calls, get more website visitors, and then down here at the bottom, get more leads. Now, if we use the get more calls, what's going to happen is you're gonna have a call now button that's in the description of your ad. So let's go ahead and open this up. I'm gonna pretend like I'm creating an ad that, again, is getting more calls. That's the goal, for them to call us. Now, if you look over here, I'm not gonna actually create the ad and do the text and all the copy and all the rest of it. LandscapeBusinessCourse.com kind of breaks down more about how to set up the actual text and the creative. But what I wanna really just show a 30,000 foot view of what this looks like. You can see here it says call now. So what that means is when they click that button, they're literally calling our office and gonna be getting set up for an estimate. What that means is that the creative and the text need a point to them giving us a call. Don't say visit our website in the text if there's a call now button. Right now, keep in mind, it's a lot of kind of people really have to commit to you to some degree to actually give you a phone call. So you might not get 50, you know, calls tomorrow. It's gonna cost more to get a call than it is just a click. All right, so clicks, cost per click is what we're most, you know, familiar with. This is not cost per click. This is really cost per call. Now, let's go back and see what a cost per click would actually be. So I'm not gonna save this. Let's go ahead and leave this one. Get more website visitors, that's really clicks. That's website visitors, just traffic to your website. Now, this one's not a bad strategy if you just got started and you're trying to drive a lot of traffic to your website, really just for search engine optimization and Google ranking, to be able to see that you get a lot of traffic to your site. Not a bad option, but again, there's a higher budget type of strategy. You're spending quite a bit of money. But if we wanted to click on this one, what's gonna happen now is instead of a call now button, we can actually determine what this button here says. So right now it says apply now, but we can actually scroll down here and actually change the button what it's going to say. So let's go here, see the button label. There's a whole bunch of different things you can do. There's a couple that I like the most. Contact us is a great one. And that's gonna be, again, you need to make sure that the text and the creative point them in the direction of contacting you. So whether that be going to your website and filling out a form, whether that be filling out a landing page, whether it be when you click on the contact us button, it goes to your contact page. Whatever it is, make sure that your creative and your text of the ad itself is actually going to the appropriate place when they click on the button. So this is another great strategy of getting web traffic to your site. Contact us is the one I would recommend here. Now let's talk about the third and final way to be able to get leads, new customers for your lawn care business. And that is the goal of this ad being get more leads. Now this one's a little more complex. This is definitely a higher strategy level. If you've never ran Facebook ads, I would not start with this one. What is very valuable about this platform, this ad product from Facebook, is that traditionally, if I send someone to my website, there's gonna be a big drop off of the amount of people who show up to the website to the amount of people who actually fill out the estimate request form and give us their information so we can give them an estimate. What Facebook allows you to do is, where do we collect their information? On Facebook. That's a great thing because now people don't have to leave on their device. They don't have to leave Facebook. They don't have to leave the app. And by the way, Facebook already knows their address and their phone number and their name. So what we're doing by allowing them to fill out the contact form on Facebook is reducing the friction before they go from a potential lead to actually submitting information that we need to give an estimate to them. So without them leaving Facebook, and there's a massive drop off of the amount of people who will click on, say for example, website visitors that click on the button, contact us, and then never fill out a form, never give you a call, but you're already paying for those people. What that means though is that the get more leads function on Facebook, they're gonna fill this out, it's gonna be very fast. There's two drawbacks. Number one, cost. The cost of getting an actual lead form filled out on Facebook is gonna be much, much higher than a click or a call. But again, not all leads are created equal. A click to your website is much, much, much less valuable than getting someone's contact information, their email, their address, having all the information you need to call them back, follow up with an estimate. The other drawback with this is going to be the fact that it not only is it more expensive, it's kind of a pain to get leads right now from this form. You need to go into your Facebook Ads Manager account every single day to get these leads manually. Facebook will not email you directly and tell you, oh, so-and-so with this form has been filled out. You actually have to go into your account and actually get the data from them every day or two. So again, this is a higher, it's gonna cost you more. It's going to be definitely less clicks, less traffic to your website. You might pay for this one, a lead, you might pay $30 to $40 per lead form that's filled out. We go back here, that would be a good kind of average, I would say, in terms of a lead form on Facebook. Whereas if we go back to, let's go back here to get more calls, you might pay $2 to $3 for an actual phone call coming into your office, getting an estimate. Get more website visitors might only cost you 20, 30, 50 cents to actually get a click. But again, there's gonna be a drop off in the amount of people who click, the amount of people who actually contact you for an estimate by either filling out a website form or giving you a call. The bottom line is in your creative, which is your picture or video, and the text and the headline, the title of your Facebook ad, you need to be very clear as to what the next stage is for the customer to click on said ad. So if you're gonna be talking about call now, reference that in your text. If you're gonna have them go to your website and fill out a form, put that in the actual text. Say, click on the button that says contact us, fill out the form, and we'll get an estimate to you within 24 hours. So those are the three different types of Facebook ads that I would recommend for you to get started. Number one, get more calls. Number two is your clicks and your web traffic. Number three is your lead forms. And in that order, there's gonna be a difference of the cost per click, the cost per interaction, the cost per impression. So keep that in mind when it comes to your budget. Don't be disappointed when you're paying $40 per lead form and only 30 or 40 cents per click, because not all leads are created equal, especially on Facebook. I hope that was helpful. If you have questions, comment below more about Facebook ads, and we'll be getting to more strategies that if you have the money to spend beyond door hangers, beyond pounding the pavement, beyond shaking hands, getting to know people, if you have the money to spend, Facebook is a great strategy to get more customers for your lawn care business. I'm Mike Andes, landscapebusinesscourse.com. We'll see you next time.